You know, on my getaways, I like to take in a little bit of history, and here in Story City, I found a place that's almost a century old and has never been closed once, the Story Theater and Grand Opera House. So I'm here inside the Story Theater in Grand Opera House with owner Todd. Todd, thanks so much for having us.
Sure.
And if my memory serves me right, we've met before.
Yes.
It's like you're kind of relaxed and you're sitting front row with your feet up, just having a great time.
You came down and had a good time with us.
That's right. Well, it's good to see you again. So you're the owner of this place.
Yes.
What's the deal with this theater?
Well, it's an old theater that was built in 1913, and it's never closed.
Really?
The Story Theater Grand Opera House is never closed.
So almost a century old,
yes.
And it's never closed.
Never closed.
So what kind of things can people come here and see? I mean, is it a functioning movie theater?
Yes, yeah. We have movies like nearly every weekend of the year, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And then the stage we restored in 1988, so the local theatrical troupe in town.
Really?
Those shows on the stage.
So mainstream movies and stage show.
Yeah.
That's really cool, too. And how did you get involved?
Well, I started helping out here in high school in the 70s. And then the two brothers that I took over from, the Peterson boys, and I've been doing it since 1983 now.
Sure. That's really cool. And how many people can fit in here?
There's 388 seats total.
Wow.
280-some on the main floor, and then 90-some upstairs, nearly 100 upstairs.
Now, has any of this been renovated, or is this all from the 30s?
No, what you see in the canopy when you came in the door, and this box office, and the interior of the auditorium was remodeled in the 30s, and that's the last time anything's ever been done.
Wow, so it's all original decor,
yep.
Original seats,
yep.
All that stuff.
Yep. You know, like I said, I started helping out in high school, and I've always loved movies. I was born and raised in Story City, so in addition to this, I run a newspaper across the street. I took over, I had a good opportunity with the Peterson boys, and they wanted to see it continue.
That's really cool. Well, would you mind showing me around the place?
Sure.
Let's do it. Backstage, huh? VIP access, huh?
That's right. This is the part that was actually closed down in the 40s.
How big is this stage?
The opening is 28 feet wide, and the depth, I want to say maybe 20 feet.
If you can't tell, the Story Theater is dripping in character. Starting with the original balcony seating to the screen stage area, the Grand Opera House is one of a kind. I read that you guys have the biggest movie screen in the state?
No, it's not the state. We used to claim that it was the widest screen in the Story Town, and that's probably not accurate anymore. I think there's bigger, taller screens.
Sure.
Years ago, we promoted that because at the time, there was a time it was.
That it was the biggest screen. Okay, so not the biggest, but there's something to be said for having a 50-year-old projector and the walls being lined with marks of community history.
Believe it or not, when we fixed up the stage, we rewired the whole building. But before we rewired, this old light board was actually still being used.
Oh, wow. Over 100 years old and never closed? I gotta try out my acting chops here. To be or not to be, that is the question. Oh, thank you, thank you. You're too kind, not to mention liars.